In June 2019, the body of 2-month-old Dylan Groves was found 30 feet down in a well in Otway, Ohio. Steve Gambill, a firefighter with the Otway Fire Department, stated how the body was found.
It was two milk crates. The milk crates were tied together, open end to open end. They were tied with copper wire, I believe, tie wire, it looked like they used. It could even been a few tie wraps or zip ties on it. Then there was a chain wrapped around it with padlocks. And you could see the rocks inside it.
Okay. Did you notice anything else at that point?
You noticed there was a package inside of it. Yes.
Gambill also described the rocks they used to weigh the crate down and how they had to pump out about 13 feet of water from the 30-foot well. Another firefighter, Dan Shirey, said that it took about 3 hours to recover the body and estimated the crates weighed about 70 to 80 pounds. Dr. Susan Brown from the Montgomery County Coroner's Office performed the autopsy and toxicology report on the infant. She determined that the baby died from homicidal violence but stated she could not say precisely what object or method caused the numerous injuries to Dylan. Some of the injuries, including rib, leg, arm, and skull fractures, were in different stages of healing, and she estimated that there were at least 3 violent incidents. Methamphetamine and amphetamine were also found in his system. A typical autopsy could not be performed because his body was decomposing from being concealed in water for months. The body had been wrapped in numerous layers of plastic and duct tape. Brown said, quote, "This was a lot of work, a large extent to go through in order to conceal this child's body so that it would not be found," end quote. On January 10th, 2019, Dylan Groves was born to Jessica and Daniel Groves. He was then placed in foster care after 5 days of recovering in the hospital due to umbilical scans showing that Jessica had taken enough drugs to affect the child during pregnancy. While in foster care, Dylan began to grow and slowly recover. After a short time, he was returned to his parents. Authorities attempted to contact the parents until they finally found them near their home in late February. They were riding a four-wheeler, and a chase ensued when they did not adhere to the sheriff's orders to pull over. They escaped through a field into a wooded area. The next time contact was made, it was from Children's Services in mid-March 2019. Baby Dylan was in good health in a long-sleeve onesie inside the Groves residence. This visit was the last known date he was alive. On June 10th, 2019, after a 30-minute standoff, Jessica surrendered to police. Daniel had to be removed with the aid of a police robot. The couple had failed for months to provide access to their home so a welfare check of Dylan could be completed. After hours of questioning, Daniel would admit that Dylan was dead. This was in stark contrast to what Jessica was telling the police. She stated that social services had taken her child months prior. Police knew her story was a lie, and with Daniel's admission, the couple was arrested and formally charged with murder. On the first day of the trial, Jessica took a plea deal and admitted all charges against her. She hoped the agreement could aid her husband in lessening his sentence. She admitted to the damages on Dylan's body and murdering him in late March. The pair had 11 felony charges pending against them. They ranged from aggravated murder and felonious assault to gross abuse of a corpse, and more. Robert Stratton, Jessica Groves' attorney, stated that the beginning of recovery was taking responsibility for one's actions and claimed Jessica was doing just that. He said she alone caused the injuries that led to Dylan's death. He concluded by defending Daniel, stating that he was foolishly unaware of Dylan's injuries. Stratton said Daniel found his son dead on March 28th, which led him into a panicked and confused state. This led him to hiding, bounding and disposing of Dylan's body, yet he did not act in his murder. Daniel's attorney, Miss Scott, stated that Jessica was the principal perpetrator and, as such, should exonerate Daniel as he was not responsible for the death of Dylan. On January 10th, 2020, what would have been Dylan's first birthday, the jury found Jessica Groves guilty on all charges and Daniel Groves guilty on all charges except aggravated murder.
The jury has returned their verdict. Jury is to count one, aggravated murder. We, the jury, having been duly impaneled, find the defendant, Daniel A. Groves, not guilty of count one of the indictment, aggravated murder. Jury has to count one of the indictment charge, aggravated murder. The jury has found, we, the jury, having been duly impaneled, find beyond a reasonable doubt the defendant, Jessica Groves, guilty of count one of the indictment, aggravated murder.
Daniel was sentenced to 47 years to life in prison, while Jessica was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole plus 32 years.